إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين اللهم لا علم إلا ما علمتنا اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما واجعل ما نتعلمه حجة لنا لا علينا ونسألك اللهم التوفيق والسداد والعون على الخير وألا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين معاشر إخوتي الكرام. My beloved brothers and sisters, the reflection today will be about 10 things that can prevent a person receiving and being afflicted with sihr, ayn, or hasad. 10 things that if a person does, it can stop the person from being afflicted with sihr, magic, and al-ayn, evil eye, and also al-hasad, jealousy. These 10, inshallah ta'ala, are 10 that are taken from the kitab Bada'i' al-Fawa'id by Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala. He mentions these 10. So 10 things if you do, these 10 things will stop you, and it will prevent you, inshallah ta'ala, from evil eye, magic, and it will also prevent you from any jealousy. My beloved brothers and sisters, a believer in all of his situation and in all of his affairs, he runs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah is the one who he turns back to. Anybody who believes and knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who can uplift anything, then you would find them run to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you know your cure is in his hands, then you would be found running to where the cure lies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one that we should seek awn, aid, a tawfiq, ability to help, and salah, rectification of our situation, and any good to come to us. A person, my beloved brothers and sisters, he could be afflicted with evil eye, jealousy, and all of these things, they can affect a person's affairs. It can affect the person's situation. The person may become sick. The person may become ill. And other things may happen to them. And a lot of the people, when this happens to them, they don't actually know the way to cure themselves. And they don't know how to deal with this particular situation. How many people do we know who've been afflicted with these illnesses, but the cure they looked for was through people who made the illness even worse? What they did to them was khurafat, things that have no textual evidences. What they did to them was matters that are of misguidance. And the reason for this is because those who are ill and have these illnesses, they have no knowledge, or they have little knowledge, and they have little insight. And those who are curing also have little knowledge and little insight of the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my aim and objective, inshallah ta'ala, is what are the cures for anyone who is afflicted with any of those illnesses. Al-sihru, wal-aynu, magic, evil eye, and even jealousy. So I'm taking it from the kitab, as I said to you, Bada'i al-Fawa'id by Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. He mentions it all in there. And bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, we will go through one after the other. I remember there was a person who came to me once, and he asked me, what is it that he would advise me to do? Because he had magic done on him. And I tried to explain these 10 points for him. And alhamdulillah, after a period of time, when he followed these 10 points, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cured him from the illness that he had, the magic. So these 10 are inshaAllah ta'ala fundamental. The first of them is at-ta'awudhi billahi. It is to seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you seek refuge to him subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. Say, Muhammad, I seek refuge in the one who blows. مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقِ, the evil in which he created. وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبْ وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ. This is what I want from the ayah. وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ. From the evil of the one who blows. And the ones who blow here are the magicians. The person seeks refuge in Allah from them. And he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone to protect them from it. Allah told us in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَعْتَصِمْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ هُدِيَ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. The person who sticks to Allah, meaning he runs to Allah, then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will guide you to that which is good. He says in another ayah, فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. Run back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ نَزْغٌ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ. When you get harmed by the shaytan, then seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah says in another ayah, وَقُلْ رَبِّ أَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ هَمَزَاتِ الشَّيَاطِينِ وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ رَبِّ أَنْ يَحْضُرُونَ. Say, Muhammad, وَقُلْ رَبِّي, say, my Lord, أَعُوذُ بِكَ, I seek refuge in you, مِنْ هَمَزَاتِ الشَّيَاطِينِ, from the affliction and the calamity of the shayateen, and the harms that the shaytan afflicts the person with, you seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not one who will not aid his slave after he's run to him. The second thing that the person needs to do is taqwa Allah Azza wa Jalla. The second thing that the person needs to come with is taqwa Allah. He should come with taqwa. And what's the haqiqa of taqwa? What does it actually mean? What is taqwa? Talq ibn Habib rahimahullah, he said taqwa means an ta'mala bi ta'atillah. It means that you act in obedience of Allah, ala nurin min Allah, from a light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you come with what? Actions of obedience. Based on what? Lakin ala nurin min Allah, based upon light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning it's legislated from Allah. Tarju thawab Allah, and that you're hoping for the reward of Allah. And then the person is doing righteous deeds. Where are they getting those righteous deeds from? They're getting it from the legislation of Allah. And who are they doing it for? They're doing it so Allah can reward them. And وَأَن تَتْرُكَ مَعْصِيَةَ اللَّهِ, and that you leave off the sins and the things that Allah prohibited you from, based on what? عَلَى نُورٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ, based on that which Allah prohibited. You're getting the prohibition from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. تَخَافُ عِقَابَ اللَّهِ, and that you're scared of the punishment of Allah. And then this is the reality of a taqwa. You come with that, and this inshaAllah ta'ala will allow Allah to protect you from the evil eye, from the magic, from the people who are jealous, who want to harm you. Allah will protect you from them. Allah says in the Quran, وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ, that the final ending is for the people who are pious, who come with taqwa. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says to us, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ, anyone who has taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا, Allah will make for you a opening. Allah will make for you what? A makhraj, a opening for you. وَيَرْزُقُهُ, Allah will provide for you, مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ, from places that you did not think so. Places that you were not expecting things to come to you from, Allah brings it to you subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah says in another ayah, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ يُسْرًا. Anybody who comes with the taqwa of Allah, what will Allah do? Allah will make your matters easy. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ يُسْرًا. And the ayn and the sihr and the heart illness that you're afflicted with, Allah will make easy. He will take it away from you. He will uplift it from you. Because what did you come with? You came with taqwa, التيسير وحسن العاقبة وصلاح الأمر وسداد الرأي وتحقق الخير والبركة. All of these are min thimari taqwa. All of that you gain when you come with taqwa and piety of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah says in another ayah, وَإِن تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا لَا يَضُرُّكُمْ كَيْدُهُمْ شَيْئًا. Allah says, if you come with patience and if you come with piety, then the harm that they are trying to afflict you with will not hurt you. Allah is talking about the disbelievers. And when the disbelievers are trying to plot against the Muslims, if you come with two characteristics, وَإِن تَصْبِرُوا, if you're patient, وَتَتَّقُوا, and you come with taqwa, Allah says, لَا يَضُرُّكُمْ, it will not harm you, O Muslims. كَيْدُهُمْ شَيْئًا, their plotting and their planning will not harm you. And this is also for the shaitan. If you come with patience and you come with taqwa, it will not harm you. Allah also says in another ayah, وَإِن تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا لَا يَضُرُّكُمْ كَيْدُهُمْ شَيْئًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطٌ. Allah knows that which they are doing. And you all know the famous hadith of the Prophet, احْفَظِ اللَّهَ يَحْفَظْكَ احْفَظِ اللَّهَ تَجِدْهُ تُجَاهَكَ. Protect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's commands, and also protect what? The prohibitions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, safeguard it. And also protect Allah's boundaries. And what would Allah do for you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect your health. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect your religion. Pay attention here, brothers. احفظِ الله يحفظك. Protect Allah. Three things if you protect, Allah will protect two things for you. What is it that you need to safeguard? You need to safeguard Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's awamir, that which He commanded you, by making sure you come with it. You also need to do hifz of Allah, His nawahi, the things that He prohibited, that's two. And the third one is, you also have to protect Allah's hudud, the boundaries that He set, and make sure everybody knows where the boundaries are drawn. If you come with those three, Allah will protect two things for you. He will protect for you your worldly affairs, and He will also protect for you what? Your hereafter affairs. ولذلك العلامة ابن رجب الحنبلي رحمه الله, the hadith of Abdullah ibn Abbas in Tirmidhi, this hadith, احفظ الله يحفظك احفظ الله تجده تجاك إذا سألت فاسأل الله وإذا استعنت فاستعن بالله. This hadith, ابن رجب الحنبلي, he wrote a whole explanation on it by itself, and he explained it. He called the book in which he explained this hadith, he called it نور الاقتباس في شرح وصية النبي لابن عباس. He called it نور الاقتباس في مشكات وصية النبي لابن عباس. It's a kitab which is مطبوع متداول. It's published. After he explained it in his kitab جامع علوم والحكم, he had to go and explain it again because of what he saw in this hadith. And many of us here, we want Allah to protect our worldly affairs. And what falls under our worldly affairs? Our health, our money, our children. Together, Allah protects that for you. But when does He protect that for you? احفظ الله يحفظك. And then taqwa falls under that. Taqwa, it falls under that. Look what Allah said in the Quran. وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَفَتَحْنَ عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, if the people of the village, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا, Allah said, if the people of the village, they came with iman and they came with piety, Allah says, لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ, Allah says, we would open for them. Allah is saying this, لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتِ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ, we will open the blessings of the sama' for them. وَالْأَرْضِ, and we will open the blessings of this earth for them. What's from the blessings of the sky that Allah will open for them? الصِّحَّةُ وَالْعَافِيَةُ. Allah will give you cure, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you health, and Allah will give you righteous children. Number three, the third thing that will help you when it comes to ayn, when it comes to sihr, when it comes to the hasad of the people, is as-sabru ala aduwihi, that the person is patient upon their enemy. Patience. You come with these characteristics, this noble characteristics of patience. Patience helps you. Who does it help? It helps you against anybody who tries to harm you. And patience, ya ikhwati al-kiram, as Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, he said, it's a matiyyatu la yadhillu rakibuha. It's a boat that if a person goes on, they will make it through. It's like the ark of Nuh. Anyone who went on that ark will make it through, and anyone who didn't will not. And then patience is like that. And through patience, the individual, the person will attain and will receive what he will receive from it, cure. That's what Allah said in the Quran, وَلَا يَحِيقُ الْمَكْرُ السَّيِّئُ إِلَّا بِأَهْلِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us, وَلَا يَحِيقُ الْمَكْرُ. This planning and this plotting that the person put to you, it will only go back to the people who did it. So that's what you know. That if they plan against you, your response to them is patience. ولذلك ابن القيم said a very powerful statement. He said, من تصر إنسان على حاسده وعدوه بمثل هذا المقام العظيم مقام الصبر. He said, a person does not receive victory he cannot receive victory better than coming with the station of patience when it comes to dealing with your enemies and those who have jealousy to you. The best way to deal with them is what? Is by having patience and by being an individual who restrains himself. ولذلك, what does patience mean? It means حبس النفس. It's to restrain your nafs. ولذلك, every time this person does something wrong to you, let what they are doing to you and the oppression that they are doing to you, make it an army for yourself. Don't make it something that works against you. بمعنى, وصنع من الليمون شرابا حلوة. Make from the bitter lemonade, add sugar to it to make it good. Everything that's done, thrown at you, try to change it for the good. And don't look at it as what? Don't look at it as a negative thing. Try to find something positive that you can give yourself. Number 4, التوكل على الله عز وجل. Relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tawakkul means thiqqatul qalb. That at this time that you're going through the evil eye, at this time the magic has been done to you, at this time when you see there's a lot of people are jealous at you, have tawakkul. Reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-thiqqah. Belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be enough for you. Alaysa Allahu bikafin abda. Is Allah not enough for his slave? Isn't Allah enough for you subhanahu wa ta'ala? Didn't Allah say in the ayah, وَمَا يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَوَ حَسْبُهُ. The one who has reliance in Allah, that Allah is enough for them. Didn't he say that? So you believe in that. And you remember the hadith of the Prophet, the hadith that I mentioned before, hadith Ibn Umar, which is, وَعَلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةِ لَوْ اجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَنْ يَفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ أَمَنْ لَمْ يَفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَكَ. That if the ummah come together and they want to benefit you, they can only benefit you in that which Allah wrote. They can't benefit what wasn't written. And if the ummah try to come together and to do what? أَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ to harm you. لَمْ يَضُرُّوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ. They cannot harm you except that which was written for you. رُفِعَتِ الْأَقْلَامِ. The pens were raised. وَجَفَّتِ الصُّحُفِ. And the scrolls were dried. So the person knows. Nabilahi Musa, when Fir'aun was after him, and Fir'aun wanted to destroy him, and they came to the ocean, and they're right in front of it, and they look behind, and who do they see? They see Fir'aun with his army, and if Fir'aun grabs them, he's going to destroy and kill them. So what do they say to Musa? They say to Musa, Inna lamudrakun. Musa, we are caught up. They've caught up with us. We're going to be destroyed. This is it. It's finished. Musa said a statement that shows how much he believes in Allah. Al-thiqqatu billah. What did he say? Kalla inna ma'iya rabbi sayahdeen. He said, no, inna ma'i, with me is Rabbi, my Lord, sayahdeen. He will guide me to what is fit, what is right at this particular moment. He will take me out of it. And what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do after that statement came from Nabiullah Musa, and he was seen that his belief of Allah is so great? Allah then said to him subhanahu wa ta'ala, اضرب بعصاك البحر. Then take your stick and hit it on the edge of the ocean. And then what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made the ocean and He broke the ocean into فَانْفَلَقَ فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْطِ الْعَظِيمِ. The whole ocean, the water, it went up and it became like mountains. And the earth became dry, even that the water were on it a couple of seconds ago. It became dry for them to walk on it. And Allah made them subhanahu wa ta'ala go through it quicker. Then Fir'aun, he couldn't catch up with them. And when he got into the ocean and they got out, what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought it together. So who is it that helped them? Allah. So when you brothers and sisters think, when you come to a place and you think all the roads are closed on you, have with you, كَلَّا إِنَّ مَعْيَ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِيمُ. No, rather my Lord is with me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He is the one who will take me out of everything which I'm in. Nabiullah Yunus ibn Matta, Nabiullah Yunus, the same. Who did he run to when he went into the stomach of the Hoot? Who was it that he went back to, who he knew that can help him? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because all of them knew the one that they rely on and the one that they know is going to help them is Allah. There's a hadith al-Imam al-Bukhari narrated in his Sahih min hadith Jabir ibn Abdullah radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in one of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's expeditions, the Prophet went out, and when he went out, he slept under a tree. And when he slept under the tree, the Prophet, he put his weapon on the tree, alayhi salatu wasalam, and he went to sleep. And when the Prophet woke up, there was a man on top of the Prophet's head. He had the sword of the Prophet. And he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَن يَمْنَعُكَ مِنِّي. Who is the one who can stop you? Who is the one who can stop me from harming you right now? And who did the Prophet say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He said it three times. فَقُلْتُ اللَّهَ ثَلَاثًا. The Prophet said, I said Allah three times. I said Allah, Allah, Allah can help me. And look how Allah helped him, alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah took him out of his situation. The sword fell out the hand of the man, and it went into the hand of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And then when the Prophet grabbed it, he said, who do you think can stop me from you, Amr? And then he said to me, you're a good man. You won't do anything to me. So what does this show you? It shows you that the Prophets of Allah, they had a thiqqa billahi. They relied on him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number five, what's the fifth cure from ayn and sihr? And this is faragul al-qalbi min al-inshighali bihi wal-fikru fihi. Get rid of and stay away from thinking about the things that this problem that you have. Get rid of thinking of it and always having it on your mind. Some people, they spend their time sitting around and really focusing on Fulan, he's got hasad with me. Wallah, I think the ayn came. And all of the time they're spending on this issue, leave it and get away from it. وَلِذَٰلِكَ the poet, he said, وَلَقَدْ أَمُرُّ عَلَى السَّفِيهِ يَسُبُّنِي فَأَمُرُّ ثُمَّةَ وَأَقُولُ لَا يَعْنِينِي. He said, I will go by the dim-witted one insulting me. I'll see him insulting me. And then I will go by him and I will say to myself, وَأَقُولُ لَا يَعْنِينِي. Maybe he doesn't intend me. He means somebody else. Then I become heedless. I don't really give too much intention, too much consideration to what this individual is saying. وَلِذَٰلِكَ one of the things that a person has to really understand is, don't allow another person to live in your heart and mind and not pay rent. If you go to a house, you pay rent in order to stay there. Another person is spending his time in your mind and there's nothing you're taking from it other than stress and headache. So don't allow somebody else to be in your mind. Give it away. وَلِذَٰلِكَ Ibn al-Qayyim says, وَهَذَا مِنْ أَنْفَعِ الْأَدْوِيَةِ وَأَقْوَى الْأَسْبَابِ الْمُعِينَةِ عَلَى اندِفَاعِ شَرِّهِ. He said, one of the greatest ways to bring about cure and push away harm is by being a person who is heedless in that regard. That doesn't really give a lot of... Some people, if you say something to them, they look into it too much. And when you shake that brother's hand, you smiled. Why not me? And they look too much into things, too much. So, don't be a person like that. فراغ القلب من الانشغال bihi wal fikru fihi. And we have this illness that people, every, you haven't called me this couple of weeks, I think you have something in your heart towards me. I was busy, I didn't have the time to call. So people take things in their hearts, they got, so the person shouldn't be like that. وَلِذَٰلِكَ, one of the things that increase illnesses is when the person really thinks about it too much. They become depressed, they become stressed. What's the best way to get rid of things? Busy yourself with something very productive in your life. Don't sit around and mourn about what a person said to you or a way a person had dealt with you. Move on. Why? لَا تُخْرِجُ الْأَمْوَاتَ مِنْ قُبُورِهِمْ. Don't bring the dead out of their graves. That's the past tense. That's what happened in the past. Why are you bringing the dead out of their graves and that goes against nature and it goes against everything. The wind goes forward. Everything goes forward. Why are you going backwards? Go forward in your life. The fact that you're stopping and you're halting, maybe that's what your enemy does want you to do. He wants you to stop and stand there so he can catch up with you. But don't let that be. Number six is al-iqbalu ala Allah, turning to Allah with sincerity. Iblis made a promise in the hellfire. What did he say he's going to do? In Jannah, what did he say? فَبِعِزَّتِكَ لَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. Who did Allah say he's going to be saved? إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمُ الْمُخْلَصِينَ. The only people Iblis cannot misguide are people who have ikhlas. Then shaitan, sihr, ayn, all of these are from shaitan. So the way to get rid of shaitan to come into your life and not to cause you harm is by doing what? Is by coming with ikhlas and sincerity. Number seven is تجريد التوبة إلى الله من الذنوب. It is to repent. Sins are reasons why sometimes you get afflicted. And wallahi brothers, I'll teach you a very important point. Our pious predecessors, when something happened to them, they would always point at themselves. Like for example, if they saw their wife not obey them and they found that their children are not listening to them, they would not say that the children are bad. And they wouldn't say that the wife is bad. This is what they would say. They would say, أَعْصِ اللَّهَ, I would disobey Allah. فَأَرَى أَثَرَ ذَلِكَ, I then see the effects of my sins on my family, my wife, my children. They would always point at themselves. Because this is the qa'ida Qur'aniyah. وَمَا أَصَابَكُمْ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ. You are not afflicted with a calamity and a problem, except what? فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ. Except it is what your hands have put forth. The illnesses and the problems that we have to admit it came from us. Allah, because when you say you're a good person but your wife is bad, or you say you're a good person and your children are bad, then you're saying Allah is oppressing you. You're saying Allah is what? He's oppressing you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's better to say, I did wrong, that's why Allah is putting me through this. So the person has to understand that. وَلِذَٰلِكَ Allah says to us, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا. Oh, those of you who believe, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a tawbah which is nasuha. What is a tawbah nasuha, brothers? It means a tawbah which three conditions are found. Number one, النَّدَمُ عَلَى فِعْلِ الدَّمْ. You regret this sin that you did. You regret it, whenever you remember it. Number two, الْإِقْلَاعُ عَنْهَا تَمَامًا. You fully walk away from that sin and you get away from it and any path that might lead you to it and any individual that you're hanging around with who's making you do this sin, stay away from them. And last but not least, al-azmul akid, that you come with this unwavering conviction, ala adam al-audati ilayhi, that you're never going to go back to the sin again. In your heart you have this conviction, I'm never going to do that again. I'm never going to do that again. When those three conditions are present, then what does this person come with? They've come with a tawbah nasuha. If it's connected to a human being's rights, then of course there's an additional fourth one that you need to come with, which is you have to ask for forgiveness. Ask that person to forgive you for what you said or done to them. ولذلك ابن القيم says, فما سلط على العبد من يؤذيه إلا بذنب يعلمه. Ibn al-Qayyim says something very powerful, that a person is not afflicted with somebody who harms you. There's somebody out there who's trying to harm you, somebody who's trying to cause you hardship, a person who's trying to do wrong to you. Ibn al-Qayyim says, Allah doesn't bring about somebody who's harming you except of a sin that you did that you know. You know you did something wrong. وَمَا لَا يَعْلَمُهُ الْعَبْدُ Or that which the slave does not know that he did. Some sins we don't know we did. So it's always important that we ask Allah for forgiveness, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number 8 is as-sadaqah. Sadaqah, giving charity. It helps you from evil eye, magic, sihr, etc. Evil eye. وَلِذَٰلِكَ the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say? As-sadaqatu tutfi'u ghadab al-rabbi. That the sadaqah, it extinguishes the anger of your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another hadith, the Prophet said, Dawu mardakum. The Prophet said, Dawu mardakum bis sadaqah. The Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam, he said, cure your ill ones with sadaqah. So if a person is ill, a person has an illness, what to do is to give sadaqah in their way. Ibn al-Qayyim says, فَإِنَّ لِذَٰلِكَ تَأْثِيرًا عَجِيبًا فِي دَفْعِ الْبَلَاءِ وَدَفْعِ الْعَيْنِ وَالشَّرِّ الْحَاسِدِ One of the things that pushes away the calamities and the evil eye and the jealousy is when you give sadaqah in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number 9, إِطْفَاءُ نَارِ الْحَاسِدِ وَالْبَاغِي وَالْمُؤْذِي بِالْإِحْسَانِ إِلَيْهِ This person who's oppressing you, this person who is jealous of you and he is harming you, to be good towards them. It is to what? It is to be good towards them. Allah says in the Quran, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ The good and the bad are not equal. Then Allah says, اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ Repel and do in return good. فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ If you do that, the person who had enmity towards you is going to be a close friend of yours. Just be give him a gift. Give him what? Give him a gift. وَلِذَٰلِكَ It's very hard when somebody does wrong to you and has oppressed you and has wronged you to forgive them. Forgiving them is hard. Imagine doing good for them. Forgiving them is hard. But imagine if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to you, اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِهِ أَحْسَنْ Do that which is excellent. Give them a gift or something, do something for them. It's hard to attain, right? That is some of the ulama they mentioned. The way to attain that station is to what? It is to make dua for that person في ظهر الغيب. When you're not with that person, make dua for them. When you're not with them, ask Allah to guide them to that which is good. That Allah shows them their mistakes. That Allah allows them to be better people. That Allah gives them a good offspring. And that Allah tabarak and you say, etc. If it happens, the person you were making dua fi dhahri al-ghayb behind closed doors, you now come and you face them face to face. Can you be harsh towards them if you were making dua all this time for them? And you know you were making dua, the scholars have said it's hard for you to do so. So the best way to do is to ask Allah's forgiveness for them. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to what? To be good towards them. وَلِذَٰلِكَ brothers, we have to ponder over one thing, which is, wouldn't you want, after you wronged and you committed so much crimes against Allah, and you did what you did, wouldn't you want Allah to forgive you? Would you not want to? Then forgive Allah the way you want to be forgiven. Sorry, forgive the people the way you want Allah to forgive you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's all it is. You want Allah to forgive you and to be kind and generous to you, then you be kind and generous to those who've wronged you. Because what you've done is you've wronged Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by going against His commands. And this is what prophets will do. Didn't Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say in the hadith of Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated a prophet ضَرَبَهُ قَوْمُهُ His people beat him حَتَّى أَدْمَوْهُ Until they made blood gush from him. The blood is gushing from him. And the Prophet, what did he say? اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِقَوْمِ فَإِنَّهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ Oh Allah, forgive my people, they do not know. He's making excuses for them. Oh Allah, forgive them. Forgive my people, فَإِنَّهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ they don't know. Number 10, which is the last one inshaAllah ta'ala, is تجريد التوحيد. The person comes with tawheed. Meaning, this person, they know with knowledge بِأَنَّ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ everything لَا يَضُرُّ وَلَا يَنْفَعَ, that everything, it cannot harm you, nor can it benefit you إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ, except with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what Allah said in the Quran, وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ وَإِنْ يُرِدْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَلَا رَادَّ لِفَضْلِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ. If Allah afflicts you with calamities and he brings you destruction, then there's no one to stop it. وَإِنْ يُرِدْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَلَا رَادَّ لِفَضْلِهِ. And if Allah wants good for you, there's nobody can turn it back. If that tawheed and that belief is in your heart, that's tawheed. That the quwwah and the qudrah and everything is in his hand. And you believe this is only him. No one else can do this. And of course, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَعَلَمْ أَنَّ الْأُمَّةِ لَوِجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَمْ يَنْفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ لَكَ وَإِنْ اجْتَمَعُوا عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَضُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَمْ يَضُرُّوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ. If you believe in that hadith, which is that if the ummah come together to benefit you, they can't except if Allah wills. And if they come together to harm you, they can't if Allah hasn't willed, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِذَلِكَ ابْنُ الْقَيِّمْ mentions that singling Allah in tawheed and having singling Allah in worship subhanahu wa ta'ala and having the correct tawheed in your heart is from one of the greatest things that uplifts illnesses from people, evil eye, magic and whatnot. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he rectifies our situation, and that he also writes for us Al-Aqibatul Hamida, a good ending, and that he guides us to the straight path. He has the ability to do so. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.